Hi folks, this is David Kwan. So, what's interesting is that I actually own pretty much all Assassin's Creed games. The only games that I don't own are the handheld spin-offs, the Assassin's Creed game for the DS, I think there was one, and the one for PSP, and the one for PS Vita. Except for those handheld spin-offs, I own all the Assassin's Creed games. I don't own much of the DLC, because I didn't really bother with the DLC, except for Assassin's Creed 2 DLC, just because it was so cheap. You know, I kind of wanted to see the sections, the memory sections that were not included in the main game, and they decided to sell as DLC, which I kind of regret. The DLC for Assassin's Creed 2, I didn't really like all that much. But anyway, so I realized I have all these videos on video games, and I have so much investment in the Assassin's Creed series, and I haven't really talked about any, you know, in none of my videos I talk about Assassin's Creed. So I just thought maybe just to kind of start here, and where do I begin? You know, I think Assassin's Creed 2 is a good place to start because that just is what made me so interested in this series. Assassin's Creed 1, I actually did start the series with that game, and it was really interesting. There was a lot of hype behind that game, you know, before it was released. My friend and I were like super hyped seeing the trailer. I was like, holy crap, this is really interesting. I got it. And it's like, wow, we have the entire, like, what was it, like Middle Eastern cities in the Crusades recreated. Just being in that universe was just incredible for the first 3 hours, you know, and you're doing really interesting things that now, you know, we have so many games that are kind of like Assassin's Creed now, but back then it was just like, that was like Assassin's Creed. This was so new, so novel. You know, you get to kind of get in crowds and stalk people, and then you get into it and just beat them with the face. There's bribing to do. They're just assassinating from the sky, and then you run with the guards chasing you. All these were actually kind of brand new concepts. And for the most part, I think it's like really the only Assassin's Creed games that are like really delving so much into this. Now there's like an oversaturation of Assassin's Creed games. You know, there's Assassin's Creed every year. This year, there's going to be 2 Assassin's Creed games. Well, at exactly the same year. And, you know, before it was just like we have an Assassin's Creed game and then we have an Assassin's Creed handheld spinoff in the same year. But now it's just like 2 at the same time, both of which actually do look really fantastic. But anyway, you know, but that was the first game, and it was really interesting setting, and we had this intrigue of assassins versus Templars. I mean, there is a sci-fi aspect to it. You know, I don't really know why Desmond is being forced into this bedchamber and being forced to relive the memory of his ancestor. And the fact that, like, this machine allows you to kind of relive the memory of the ancestor, the way it was done, just the premise, I think was really tasteful in the beginning. The only real problem with Assassin's Creed is that it gets super boring after about 5 hours. Because you do the same thing over and over and over again. There's like, oh yeah, you can do the side missions. You can go here and collect this. But it's the game doesn't really, you know, it doesn't feel unique, each side mission. It's just like, this is the kind of stuff that you've been doing. You're going to kill 9 Templars, or I think it was 9. And each of them are pretty much, you're going to do it the exact same way. You know, you're going to stalk this guy, you're going to beat him up, you're going to bribe this guy, you're going to go here, and do some side quests here, do some races here. You're going to do the exact same thing. You know, and then you're going to finally get to assassinate the guy. Kind of, and that's the fun part in Assassin's Creed games, for first one. Just assassination. And then, you do that for so many times until the ending sequence where it's just all combat, right? That was Assassin's Creed 1, and it just kind of ends in a really weird cliffhanger. All Assassin's Creed games do that. They all end in a weird cliffhanger, and they get weirder and weirder. It's like so weird. Assassin's Creed 3 has got to be like the worst, but I'm not going to talk about Assassin's Creed 3. So Assassin's Creed 2, I think, is really interesting because it's the one that really solidified the formula of the game. the franchise from going on, Assassin's Creed 2 was like, has been like the benchmark formula. You know, you have this main story, you have a really interesting main character who's kind of an asshole, but really charming and really a kind of a badass. He's really into his own culture. You know, we have characters in the Assassin's Creed universe who are so culturally based. You know, they are the product of their culture. You know, Altair is a product of his culture, although Altair doesn't really kind of talk that much. But Assassin's Creed 2 kind of really deviates. We have an Italian character who talks a lot, who's really machismo, and just so totally not what you think of as an assassin until he becomes one. And so that's interesting. And then you have Connor in Assassin's Creed 2 and Haytham in Assassin's Creed 3, who are also products of their cultures. And Assassin's Creed Liberation, which I think is a really amazingly... I played a little bit of it, actually. But it just delves into that. I think that's really cool. But you have side missions that connect you to historical things, which I think is really great. Among the Assassin's Creed 2 trilogy, I have to say, I don't know, it's really hard to pick a favorite. Just Assassin's Creed 2, I think, is that has to be, like, just the best game of the series, just because it kind of solidified that formula. But I look more fondly back to Revelations. I know that gets a lot of hate for some reason. It's just like, oh, this is just more Assassin's Creed. And then you're like just, cash cow. You know, they're just like just exploiting or taking advantage of Assassin's Creed fans by making this game, whatever. But I thought that was actually really good. Brotherhood introduced new concepts. But I didn't really have as much fun with Brotherhood just because it felt a bit too samey, and you're in Rome the entire time, and it felt like Assassin's Creed 1 problem. You're doing the same thing over and over again, and the story it gets kind of really weird in Brotherhood, and Assassin's Creed 2 ends really weirdly again. But it's so weird. It's like, oh, you track this one dude this whole time. Finally, you get the chance to do the deed, and Ezio's is like, nah, you're not worth it. What? Okay, at least the player doesn't get a choice. Well, that makes sense, because it's a story that happened. Giving player choice would complicate things. But it's just like, okay, what was the point of that? And then the ramifications of that, of Ezio's choice, becomes pretty clear by the beginning of the Brotherhood, and that happens. And yeah, it's just like, but Revelations, I actually really like, not because combat's refined a little bit, there's bombs you can throw, but the setting, it's Revelations. You go into this Turkey area, but it's really colorful. Like the architecture is so different from what you're used to, the Italian architecture that's been used. You go into this underground cave, or this underground city at one point, and you escape it. Burning down. There's a lot of cinematic moments in Assassin's Creed 2 Revelations that's just like, they're trying to rip off like Uncharted flair here. You know, that didn't really fly all that well. And the Altair sequences are really just kind of really more like movies than games. You know, you're just pretty much going down, walking Altair as an old character down and watching the scene happen. So there's not much fun to it, but it's really interesting how they really try to tie in all the characters together in Revelations. Maybe it didn't work for a lot of people, but I thought it was really kind of cool. You know, you get to see Altair and Ezio and Desmond on their last journey, and they all finish their journey in Revelations. They all do, and I think that's really interesting. Well, actually, no, Desmond doesn't finish. Never mind, not Desmond. Desmond finishes journey in Assassin's Creed 3, but I think it might as well end it in Revelations. It just ends so weirdly, because you finally get the apple, and you know the character that you really grew attached to, she no longer exists after Assassin's Creed Revelations, which is why you have three. I have to say, so I've been kind of juggling in my mind, which is worse, Assassin's Creed 1 or Assassin's Creed 3? I have to say 3 is my least favorite. I haven't finished 4, and I got, I'm about like 60% done with 4. 4 is amazing. I feel 4 just kind of blew my mind. It's like, okay, so after 3 I was kind of like, eh, you know, but 4 just blows my mind away. But 3 I think is the least, my least favorite. It tried to do a lot of really amazing things, but it got bogged down by a lot of different aspects. And I'll probably talk about 3 in a different video, because it's already 10 minutes talking about Assassin's Creed. But I just figured I haven't really ever talked about Assassin's Creed. So here I go, I talked about them. You know, definitely, I really like Revelations, and it kind of takes down, it takes all the fun elements of the past two games, kind of paces them on there. The Altair and Desmond sections, sure, they're kind of annoying, but there's a lot there what you can do as Ezio in these new settings and these new elements. Brotherhood was pretty cool, but it got really repetitive. And 2 is just kind of, I think, the masterpiece that combines all the things. It just is fun to do side missions, it's fun to do story missions, it's fun to explore, it's fun being Ezio, this new interesting character, and it's fun being part of this world, you know, Florence and all these kind of interesting places that were there. And that's, I think that's the draw of Assassin's Creed games, is you're living in what is like, you're being there in like the historical cities, kind of recreated with the gamer's vision in mind. And there's this intrigue of, well, not anymore, but there used to be this intrigue of assassins versus Templars. Now they have this cool end of the world thing going on. Well, that happened in Assassin's Creed 3, kind of ruined the intrigue. And then 4, I don't know, 4 goes into a really strange place. Like, every time Assassin's Creed game ends, it just goes into a stranger place, which I don't like. You know, I just feel like they go way too out of the blue. It's even with Animus, the machine. So Assassin's Creed 1, like, you know, it's you have the chair, the bed that's tied down to you. By the time you get to like the third one or the fourth one, actually, you don't even have, you need a chair anymore. You can just kind of use the tablet. It just goes into strange places, man. It's crazy. But anyway, that's my thoughts on the kind of the series overall. I'm actually really excited to see what, I won't be able to play Unity because I don't own a PS4 or Xbox One, but you know, Unity looks really amazing. But I'm more interested in actually the other one for the PS3 and 360. That one looks more like my kind of game, just because I really enjoyed Assassin's Creed 4. And I'm still going to continue to play more because I haven't finished it. But yeah, those are my thoughts. Hope you guys enjoyed. Cheers.